Namaskar. The topic of today's video is relaxation and meditation. Very often people confuse these two practices, although both of these practices are yogic practices and we need to do them every day. We need to clearly understand the difference between them. Relaxation is the passive practice. All you have to do is just to relax. You consciously relax whatever tension is there within your muscles and nerves. This is all you need to do. And meditation, while at the physical level you relax, all your muscles are relaxed, except the muscles holding the spine, holding your back straight. Everything relaxed. But at the mental level, you're mobilized. 100% of the potential, 100% of your ability to think and concentrate is engaged. This is the difference between relaxation and meditation. Many times people ask, can I do meditation in supine position, lying down? Of course you can. Meditation you can even by standing on your head. You can still do, but this is not the best posture for meditation. Because if you lie down, is posture ideal for relaxation. But it is not ideal for meditation. If you lie down on your back, almost 100% there is a chance that you will fall asleep. But we don't want to fall asleep. Often, when people start to do meditation, they do fall asleep, even in sitting posture. We say it is fishing meditation. Or sometimes it becomes a woodpecker meditation. You know, there is a bird, woodpecker, it hits. It hits the wood. So you do like this. So what to do? Why does it happen? Many people, they dope themselves either with coffee and tea, or internal doping is there, which is the stressful hormones. And they live in a state of such tension that they never relax, nor in the daytime, nor in the night. Always tense. And while sleeping, they're not actually resting properly. They're always in this state. And this condition wears out our health very, very quickly. So in meditation triggers relaxation response. There is this fight or flight response in the body when the stressful hormones are secreted. And there is the opposite relaxation response. So when you meditate, this relaxation response is triggered and your body starts to relax. Maybe for the first time of your life. And then you feel the tiredness, you feel the weariness of your body. That is why many people complain, they say, I feel so tired when I started to do meditation, I feel so tired. Yes, my dear, because you are not using doping anymore. The hormones are changed. You are not using stressful hormones. You are relaxing now. You are resting now. Your health is being restored. You have to live through this period. Become rested, become healthier, and then you won't fall asleep in meditation anymore. So if you are falling asleep in meditation, then what to do? One way is just you sit. You sit and you try to force yourself through this going asleep. Maybe you will overcome. If you manage to achieve concentration, somehow after some time you will find yourself in a very nice state of clarity and strength. But if the tiredness is too much, then you will not be able to. But your willpower is focused on meditation. So after 10 minutes of this, you will find yourself, oh, what happened? What am I doing? Ah, I'm doing meditation. And then, okay, let's start again. And you start again, and you feel already rested, and you feel very, very clear. And you will have, believe me, you will have very good meditation. Or if you feel that tiredness is too much, you know that the moment I will close my eyes, namaskar, I will fall into that world of sleep. Then just lie down in the shavasana. Shavasana is the posture for relaxation. You lie down, you put your alarm clock for 15 minutes and repeat the mantra, fall asleep, then wake up and then sit and meditate properly. Relaxation practice is also needs to be done daily. At least once a day you need to do very good relaxation. How it is done? First the posture, you lie supine position, you lie on your back. Your hands little bit apart, your legs little bit apart, and you relax each and every muscle. You start from your feet and you go relaxing. Go relaxing. I will make the video with relaxation and we will publish on this channel on YouTube. I will just record the good music and guidance, step-by-step guidance to relax. Anyway, even if it is not yet in this channel, you can find in many places in internet. I'm quite sure that there are such guided relaxation practices. So the posture is called Shava Asana. Shava means corpse. If you are dead, you don't have any bills to pay. You don't have anything to worry about. You don't have any examinations to pass. You can be completely relaxed. So mentally you let go everything. You think, now for this next 10 minutes I have no duties or obligations. I am completely free to fall into the sweet state of relaxation. And then physically you also relax. Once a day you need to do this relaxation posture. After asanas is best. And asanas are physical postures, I will speak later. In the course we will have one lesson dedicated to the special yoga postures. And twice a day we need to do meditation. To engage your mind 100% and try to expand your mind to contain the idea of infinity within yourself. So I think you understood the difference between meditation and relaxation. Relaxation is to let go the tension and to start the process of restoration of health. And meditation, although on the physical level it starts with relaxation, but the goal of meditation is to awaken the mind, is to focus the mind and to utilize the entire potential, the entire ability of the mind to concentrate and to grasp the idea of infinity, idea of infinite consciousness. It is quite two different processes, passive and active. Thank you very much for viewing this video. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to keep in touch, because on this website, Meditation Steps, something is there, and in YouTube something is there. If you are watching this video on YouTube, it is good to subscribe to meditationsteps.org, and if you are watching on the website, it is also good to subscribe in YouTube. Thank you very much.